Let us continue, inshallah. Okay, do you understand about the relationship between the action and the result?
Yes.
Okay, that's clear, yeah? Alright. You know, nawasil kalam, inshallah. طيب اما اذا لم تكتمل هذه المكونات بسبب قيام مانع خارج عن إرادة الجاني فانما يقع يعد شروعا في جنايه. Okay, if let's say the same example we said just now, if someone shoots somebody and hit in the leg for example, and then he did not die because of the shooting, and then come some other reason and then make him die, for example the car accident for example, and then he died, he can be charged under the shuru' fil jinayah. The shuru' means the attempt to kill. An attempt to kill, which is punishable also, but not, of course, not through qisas. But not also through dia, maybe by ta'zir only. Or maybe because of he causes the injury, then he can fall under the qisas of injury. Okay? But not under qisas of death, which carries the death penalty. Okay? إلا إذا كان ما وجد يشكل في حد ذات الجناية كاملة من الجناية وإن نقصت أن التي كان يجري في جنس بدوان. أوكي الركن الألبي ثم نتكلم عن ركن الألبي للجريمة. الركن الألبي we have discussed about الركن الشرعي. أوكي and then ركن المادي. Now we are talking about الركن الأدبي للجريمة. طيب وهو ما يعنيه فقهاء القانون بالركن المعنوي. So الركن الأدبي أيضا يسمى بالركن المعنوي. طيب إذ إن الجريمة ليست كيانا ماديا فقط، ولكن هذا الكيان المادي لابد هو أن يحاط برباط من الصلة النفسية التي تجمع بينه وبين من يقوم بذلك الكيان المادي للسلوك الذي أسبغ عليه المشرع صفة التجريم وعاقب على اقترافه. Okay, the meaning is if when you look at the crime, it's not does not consist of action only. Action only will not make a jinayah jinayah. For example, if someone who is not baligh, for example, killing somebody, is he liable for qisas punishment? He is not. So now we are talking about what is ar-rukn al-adabi. Ar-rukn al-adabi meaning that someone who commit crime must have a certain element, must have certain arkan, rukn al-adabi. Okay? Because why? Because this is related very much with the what you have inside you. For example, if someone killed but has the intention to kill, also cannot be charged under the killing, under qisas, because he has no intention to kill. Or someone who is killing somebody but he's not basically have the ability to kill, for example, because I have had the ability to change, to choose between killing and not killing, for example. They also make some difference in the punishment. Because someone is forced to kill somebody, for example. And there is make some difference. Even though some ulama say he must be also punished with qisas. Okay? This was okay. Walqami kama أن من يقوم بذلك السلوك لا بد وأن يكون من الأشخاص. Okay, now we're talking about the person. The action is there, the action of killing is there, but now we are talking about the person who commit the crime. Whether the person is basically eligible or liable for the type of punishment, it depends on the type of person. Okay? Now we look at this ahlan lil musa'ala. That's ahlan lil musa'ala meaning that he is liable for any type of punishment because of the age. For example, if he's not baligh and then he's not liable. For example, if he's insane, for example, he's also not liable. This is yusamma al-ruknu al-ma'nawi. Okay? The person who commit the crime must someone who is liable for the punishment because of this, his character or his what he has in himself, whether how they think, maybe if you're not insane, then he cannot think properly, and then he's not baligh or not muwayyid, for example, he also cannot think properly, then he's not liable for the punishment. Okay, this is about the الركن الأدب. أوكي، ما يكون في الركن المالي للجاري ويشفع به أهل المسألة الجنائية وذلك محاجب في عنصرين. أوكي، now how to make or how to ascertain someone you know is liable or not liable for any type of punishment because of he or she committing the crime. Number one, what decide a decider? The decider is awalan al-idrak. Al-idrak bermakna al-fahm, meaning that he has the ability to think, you know, wisely. He knows what to differentiate between good and bad. He can differentiate between right is wrong and wrong, and then only then he can be punished or is liable for the punishment. Okay, al-idrak. إذ لابد من أن يكون من يقوم من يقوم بسلوك مدركا إدراكا يعتد به حتى يمكن محاكمته على سلوكه. So he can make a choice. If someone like a kid, small children who do not understand about killing, let's say his father is actually a policeman, and then because he's too young, you know, the father just leave the gun, for example, on the table, because not thinking that it's impossible for the kid at the age of like, you know, 6 months, 7 months, you know, can use the gun. But you know, because the kid keep watching the movies, you know, shooting and all that, he knows how to use the gun. Example, is it possible? Maybe kids knows. I mean, everything from internet sometimes. Okay, the mother, father, because they are so always busy, they give the gadget to their kids, small kids, you know. As young as, you know, 6-7 months already know how to, you know, scroll and all this and looking for something, you know. They keep trying and trying. So one day, this person, you know, this small kid, about at the age of 6-7 months, you know, yeah, take the gun and then shoot his father. Then he's just playing, he has no intention. So would he be liable for kisas? Of course not. Because why? Because he's not a drug yet. He does not understand what is the consequences of using that gun, for example. Okay, the one who can be punished, only those who understand the function of a gun. He knows that when he shoot, you know, he can hurt somebody, he can kill somebody, then only then this person can be punished with the punishment. Alright? فإذا فقد هذا العنصر من قام بالسلوك إن علمت مساءلته جنائيا عما قام به استنادا لما قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم رفع القلم عن ثلاثة. If he is not having this type of you know character, okay, then he cannot be punished. For example, الصبي حتى يبلغ. الصبي حتى يبلغ وعن النائم حتى يستيقظ. Can somebody kill somebody while he's sleeping? Yes, can. Can. They call it what? They call it night walker. No, night walker. No. Okay. If somebody, let's say, I'm a simple example. If someone is so fat, okay, someone is so fat, and then one night he or she happened to sleep with his friend or her friend who is so skinny. You know, he's sleeping beside her, okay? She is sleeping, okay, he or she is sleeping together. I mean, of course, same gender, okay? But yeah, same gender, it's not different gender. I mean, one very fat, very, very fat, talk about 200 kilograms, for example. And then one night, the fat woman is, you know, so deep in sleep, and then he just, you know, keep rolling and rolling, and then yeah, one night he was rolling onto the friend, and he broke, you know, her bones and all that, and died instantly. For example. But it happened. Yeah, something happens, you know. So be careful when you go to sleep. Are you so skinny? Don't sleep with those who are so grand, you know, in the house. Wait, you know? Okay? You can be killed, you know, instantly. Okay? But, well, he has the intention, or she has the intention to kill? No, she has no intention to kill. But it happened, can happen, okay? So if you are asleep, you kill somebody, then you will not be liable for punishment, okay? وَعَنِ الْمَجْنُونِ حَتَّى يَبْرُمْ. That's a good thing here. If you feel like, you know, so desire, you have desire to kill somebody or to commit crime, you can do that. Be crazy. Okay, be an insane person, real one. And then you can kill anybody, you can do whatever you want. But if you are not coming back, it's up to you. Alright? So if you are innocent, then you are not liable for punishment also. Whatever you do, whatever you do, it's not be, you will not be punished. Okay? Alright, clear here?
Yes.
Alright. Thalihima al-ikhtiyar. The second element, the second element for al-ruknu al-ma'nawi بعد الإدراك هو الاختيار. أي أن يكون من قام بسلوك المعاقب عليه قد قام بسلوك مختارا، مختارا meaning by choice، مختارا by choice بناء على رغبة منه واختيار حر. So basically you have the choice whether to proceed with the crime or not proceeding with not proceed with the crime. So it's your choice. Then if you have been forced to steal, for example, are you liable for the punishment? You are not liable for co-punishment of stealing. Okay, for example, there must be some ikhtiyar hur, meaning that the freedom of to choose. Ikhtiyar hur bimana freedom to choose. Okay, فإذا اختلت إرادته من يقوم بالسلوك فإن تلك الإرادة تصبح إرادة معينة وعلي تنعلم مسألة صاحب هذه الإرادة المعينة لأن الأصل أنه لا يسأل جنائيا إلا من أتى متعمدا فعلا قد حرمه الشارع. So you are only liable if you had the intention to do, you know, what is considered as a crime. If you had no intention to do something, but it happens, okay, it happens, then you are not liable for the punishment. Okay, sit, come. Please. Yeah, it's you. Okay, you're on TV. Okay, read this one. Okay, read the text and then try to explain it.
اختيار أيو أن يكون من قام بسلوك المعاقب عليه قد قام بسلوك مختارا بناء على رغبة منه واختيار حر. This means that a person who is commit the crime must have choice to do it. This means that he can think that it is a crime or not, and he choose to make it.
Alright. Then?
Then
he will be?
He will be accused.
He will be liable for?
Liable for crime.
Liable for the crime. Liable for punishment. Eh? Alright, okay, thank you very much. Thank you. Just need some break, you know? Alright, okay. Now we can run. Okay? فإذا اختلت إرادة. Okay, if the إرادة is not there. Okay, if the إرادة. You don't want to kill somebody, but you are forced to be killed. If you are not killing that person, you'll be killed, for example. And you are not liable in some of the fuqaha opinions. But some fuqaha say, you are still liable. Okay, we are going to discuss about that later. Okay? And you don't want to steal, you steal, but someone threatened you. If you don't steal, okay, I'll kill your mother, for example. Yes, a real threat. You believe that it's a real threat, then if you don't steal someone's money, for example, then your parent will be killed. Then it's a real threat. Then also, if you steal, you are not liable for the punishment. Okay, because you don't have ikhtiyar. Okay, you don't have any choice, you know, you cannot choose between yes or no. Okay, so this is considered, because why? إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى مُتَعَمِّدًا. مُتَعَمِّدًا meaning that you come and commit a crime with clear intention. You know it's wrong, you know it's haram, you know it's against the law, you know there's punishment for that one, but you stick around with the crime. And then of course, you deserve. for the punishment because you know it. You are aware of the punishment of that. Okay? Alright. لِقَالِ تَعَلَى وَلَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جِنَاحٌ فِي مَا أَخْطَأْتُمْ بِهِ وَلَكِنْ مَا تَعَمَّدَتْ قُلُوبُكُمْ. Okay? Then you'll be no sin for you if you are doing it wrongfully. You don't have the intention, you do it wrongfully. You don't have intention to do, but it happened without your intention. Okay, you don't have to have any intention to kill something, then because of your action that you kill, for example, then you are not liable for the punishment. Okay? وأيضا قال تعالى وما كان لمؤمن أن يقتل مؤمنا إلا خطأ ومن قتل مؤمنا خطأ فتحرير رقبة مؤمنة ودية مسلمة إلى أهله إلا أن يصدق. Okay, also this ayah explains that someone will not, a Muslim will not ever, I mean will not be killing somebody except with the wrongful act of the person. I mean, he will not, you know, willingly doing killing except when it's only some mistakes happen. Okay, you don't supposed to be a Muslim. Don't supposed to kill somebody else because it's a sinful act. A sinful act is a very serious crime. But if it happen, because he has no intention to kill, like in accident or whatever. Okay. Okay. So ma. نواصل الكلام في موضوع الرابع. Okay, Farudin, remind me the time. Yes. Okay, how many more minutes we have? 25 or 20. Okay. Are you still okay? You want to stop early today?
Yes.
Then we can continue until 5:30. Some bonus. No. We start at 4. Don't worry. Okay, some extra here. Okay? Alright. Al-Mu'adha al-Rabi. Are you sure you want to leave early?
Yes.
Yes, sincerely?
Yes.
Because of the hot condition here?
Yes.
Is it Shara'i, you think? Is it Shara'i or not Shara'i? Is it Shara'i? Anyone going to die here?
Yes.
Anyone going to faint here?
Yes.
Huh? Anyone is going to fall unconscious here? If there is, then there is Sharia compliance. Because ad-darura tubihul mahdura. Ad-darura tubihul mahdura. If someone is dying, then of course we can cancel the class. We can make it short, the class short. Otherwise, it's stand as it is. Okay? The obligation is, my obligation is to teach you until 4. That's my obligation. And this obligation cannot be simply, you know, dropped down just like this, be dropped like that without you know, complying with that obligation, unless with some necessity. Okay, is there any necessity to cut the class short? In my opinion, it's not. Then please bear with me for the next 25 minutes inshallah. Okay? Inshallah, the ajr will be a lot bigger. Inshallah. Because why? You know what? An-naru ashaddu harra. An-naru ashaddu harra. The hellfire is not hotter than this one. This is nothing, man. This is nothing. Alright? So please bear with me. Okay, inshallah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay? Give some you know, fresh air to you. Okay? You feel it? No? You don't feel it, right? Feel in your heart, inshallah. Okay, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Al-Mawdu' al-Rabi' Qa'ida. Hunaka qa'ida. La jarima wa la uquba bila nassin fi jara'im al-hudud wal-qisas wal-diyat. Okay, in this section, basically we are going to explore, okay, the text. And the text regarding hukuk al-hudud, qisas wa-diyah wa ridhalika. Because why? We explained early on that if there is no nas, then we can consider an action is a crime. Now we're going to show you each and every type of crime which has the text in it. Okay? Okay? Now we look at this, the first one. Okay, basically we are going to first explain to you about la jarima wa la uquba illa binas bi khilal taqrim al qa'idatayn. This is the fuqa, the opinion of fuqa about this principle. Okay, la jarima wa la uquba bila nasin. This is we can say this as a principle in Sharia law. Okay. Number one, la hukma li af'al al uqala qabla wurud al nas. More or less, the meaning here is the same. Ini la jarima wa la uquba illa binas. La hukma li af'al al uqala qabla wurud al nas. Before the nas coming, okay, before the existence of any nas, then no one can be punished with any type of crime they committed, you know, before the existence of the nas. أي أن أفعال المكلف المسؤول لا يمكن وصفها بأنها محرمة ما دام لم يرد نص تحريمها. So anything that is not, there is no nas saying it's haram, we cannot say it's haram. ولا حرج على المكلف أن يفعلها أو يتركها حتى ينص على تحريمها. So there is no, it's okay for you to do or not to do because it's not clear. It's not clear whether it's haram, it's not haram. So it's we don't know. If something is not stated clearly it's haram, then we cannot say it's haram. So it's up to you whether to use it or to do it or not to do it. Okay. So مثلا الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة. There is another principle here. الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة. So the original state of anything is basically is a permission. It's basically the permission. Everything is permissible to do it except there is a not saying otherwise. Okay. الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة. The original state of anything is allowable or permissible. Okay, you can do whatever. You can choose whatever it is as long as there is no nas saying it's haram, then you can do it. Okay? Well then? Okay. فالأشياء والأفعال لا يجوز أن تعطى حكما إلا إذا كان هناك دليل شرعي على هذا الحكم. Okay, you cannot simply give any type of hukum except with the nas. You. Okay, we have to understand the right, okay, the right to choose, the right to decide whether it's haram or halal is not in our hand. It's in Allah's hand. Okay, Allah is the creator of the human being. Allah is the creator of all hukum. No one has the right to say it's haram, it's halal. No, no one. Not even Mufti, not even Prime Minister, not even the King. No one can decide it's halal or haram except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot say it's haram. Only when Allah says it's halal. You can say it's halal only when Allah says it's halal. But in general principle, is anything is permissible except there is certain hadith or certain ayah Quraniyah saying this is halal. Otherwise, it stays as it is. You know, it's all halal except there is hukum or there is hadith or Quran, ayah Quraniyah saying this is halal. If there is, for example, there's no nanas saying halal haram, okay, it can be considered as something permissible. It's very permissible. Because why? Because Allah will not say, okay, the arus, the rice is halal for you, the drinking of water from the tap is halal for you. Okay, of course, there will be plenty of it, you know. It cannot cover, I mean, in that small book, you know, cover everything. But in principle, it's like this, it's simple as that. You know, when there's no nas, saying it's haram, then it's halal, that's it. That's it. Something like that, okay? ثم قال الله سبحانه وتعالى وما كنا معذبين حتى نبعث رسولا وقال الله تعالى لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسول. Okay, this one Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran, so someone will not be punished, you know, with whatever they do except with after the revelation or after the Allah Ta'ala send down the prophet to tell them the truth about everything. Okay, if Allah Ta'ala did not send them, you know, Prophet Sallallahu to explain everything to them, so they basically cannot be punished. Cannot be blamed with something they do if there is no explanation, you know, done for them. You know, there is must be a rusul, come down, you know, from Allah Subhanahu Ta'ala to come explain, this is aqidah, the right aqidah, this you cannot believe this way, this halal, this haram. And after being explained everything, then these people can be punished if they go cross about, I mean basically they're crossing the line, then they are doing or committing crimes. Okay? وقال الله تعالى لئلا يكون للناس على الله حجة بعد الرسل. Why Allah Ta'ala would not basically punish people who basically who not been explained properly. For example, people who live in the remote area in the jungle, nobody comes to them. Nobody he knows. They know anything. They don't know anything about this world. They are in their world. No internet. No news. Nothing. Nothing. They don't know everything. They don't know anything about Islam. They don't know how to perform salah. They don't know how to worship Allah. And then they die. No one comes to them. Explain to them. Then they cannot be punished. Because why? If Allah punish them, then there will be hujjah for them. Why Allah? Why Allah? You punish me? You know, no one teach me. I never come across with somebody who tell me or explain to me about this. How can I believe in you? What? Because I don't know anything, ya Allah. You see? Allah is just. You know, Allah is always, you know, apply the justice into the human being. You know, Allah will not punish you unless you are being explained. You know, being given the explanation, clear explanation about everything. Okay? But now if you are now, you are like a student or people in this world now, you don't have any excuse. Why? Because information is everywhere. You know, even Google can help you. Even non-Muslim can know about Muslim, about Islam, by just typing Islam. Then millions of articles comes out and then he can read and you know, understand, you know, the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even though no one come and explain to them. You know? Nowadays there is no excuses. Yeah, but for all time, there's maybe then they have some excuses. Eh? Alright. إن جميع الأشياء التي جاءت في إباحة الأشياء جاءت عامة فعمومها دل على إباحة جميع الأشياء. Okay, as we explained earlier on, nothing being explained in details, just in principle. As we said, الأصل في الأشياء الإباحة. That covers everything. Anything about drinking, about clothing, about walking, about laughing, about sleeping, whatever it is, as long as not stated is haram, then it is halal for you to do it. As simple as that. Because Al-Quran will not explain everything for you. Yeah? Alright? But they only put a certain principle which, you know, we can just apply this principle to everything, you know, we do in our life. فتكون جميع الأشياء جاءت بخطاب الشارع العام فإذا حرم الشيء فلا بد من نص مخصص لهذا العموم يدل على استثناء هذا الشيء من عموم الإباحة حرمت عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير حرمت عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير. Okay, this is what is stated in the Quran. What is stated is something that is you know, you are not being slaughtered, you know, ميتة. If you're, let's say you have cows, basically, get into the well, for example, go into the river, and you can't slaughter it, but it died just like that, and then you take it away from the river, and then you eat it. Of course, it's called maita. Okay, wadama walahma al-khinzir. All this prohibited. So apart from this one, if not stated, then you cannot say it is halal. So just eat whatever you want, as long as there is not saying it is, it's halal. Okay, how many more minutes we have? Say? Oh, we have video. Okay, we stop here. Okay, welcome to our friends. Okay, who are, you know, providing our the video. Let us watching the video. Thank you very much.
Jutaan terima kasih kerana menonton video ini. Jika ia bermanfaat, sila like, share dan subscribe. Assalamualaikum dari saya, Ustaz Dr. Nik Rahim bin Nik Wajiz. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.